Welcome back. Another fun subject I love to do, armored vehicles. And because Model Rectifier Corporation is a channel sponsor, they're nice enough to send this new release of Italeri's Semovente M42 da 75 over 18. The Semovente, according to Google Translate, means self-propelled, and that makes a lot of sense. It's a self-propelled anti-tank. So it is a sweet-looking vehicle, lots of detail. Top kit, new molds. Let's take a look. There's four versions that you can build right in the box. We'll take a look at some of the extras first. We've got a beautiful set of photo etch right there. That will enhance our model. You attach photo etch with super glue or epoxy, but you can do either way. I always use super glue. It's much easier. We've got a beautiful set of decals. We'll get in nice and close, focus in. You can see all the emblems. We got a cool shamrock there. We got German logos. So you are all set for the four different versions in the manual. Mine has two complete sets of tracks. One was in the box, one was in the bags with the plastic parts. They have the exact same track number, 6569 on there, so I don't think they're different. So it looks like you just get a, might get an extra set of bonus tracks. I love that these are molded in a silver tone. Helps weather them up right away. Nice detail on them. Glueable, and these are supposed to be glueable, like it says. Photo etched fret, new glueable tracks. So that's pretty cool. We'll find out how well that works on there. Nice looking, nice detail underneath, all the way around, two complete ones. So if you make a boo-boo or you want to practice some weathering, you are all set. Now, I don't know the name of every single part on these tanks, but one thing this tank does have is a full interior, and it looks like an engine and transmission package as well. We've got stowage, we've got what looks like a radio, we've got racks for the shells. Beautiful detail on there, all molded in the tan plastic. There are not a lot of trees in this kit. Here is the bottom of the hull, front, sides, mount our suspension and road wheels and return wheels. Check out that fine molding there on all those little parts and handles. Well, it looks like they're super tiny and hard to deal with. Usually armor kits go together quite easily. Gorgeous vent work on there. It does have opening hatches if you decided to do the entire interior on the tank. See, there's what looks like the engine transmission at least. We got various small handles. Look at all these tiny little parts on there. And gorgeous little detail on them. We've got extra fuel tanks to mount. We've got seats in there for the interior. Nice, nice little rivet detail. We've got the upper hull. We've got more interior parts, seats. We've got a nice machine gun there. Gorgeous. I don't know how they get that fine barrel and the tripod there. We've got more fuel tanks. We've got more options. We've got two figures included in this kit. Beautifully molded. We'll flip the tree over and look at the front of those figures in a second. We've got more parts of the mantlet. We got what looks like parts of the main gun. Main gun's got little vents molded into it. You could drill those out if you wish. Looks like seat pads there. Back to that upper hull. Let's turn that around. Look at the beautiful detail on those figures. Check out the keister on that one guy right in our face. So if you want to position people inside and leave the hatches open, we've got a third figure. Nice detail. We've got drive wheels, return wheels, road wheels on this tree. Look at this tiny little holes molded in. Super crisp. Not seeing any bunch of flash hanging off. We're going to flip this tree as well. Look at those little leaf springs. More drive wheels for the other side. Obviously, all the drive components have to be doubled up. Nice tow cable. I've done tow cables in plastic before. Look at that. I don't even know what those are, but they're amazing. Be careful when you're cutting those off. More road wheels, tow hooks. Flip it around for the detail on that suspension. Everything is really cool looking. All the little bolt heads and rivets and shock absorbers. Back of the uniform, looking real nice. In fact, the figures are the only things that I saw any flash on. That's everything that's in the box when you get yours. I'm gonna get to building my version. I saw a picture of one online that I liked more than this three-color camo with the tan base. So that's the color I'm gonna be doing mine, but we'll get to that after I get the subassembly in a few seconds. Before I get too far in the build, I do want you to know that this kit has a full interior driver's seat, engine compartment, transmission, and shell storage, and they even include the shells. Now, I'm gonna be sealing mine up, but before I started putting the parts on and lining up, you will need to assemble part of that interior to get your sidewalls in. And once that goes in, everything else will line up beautifully and put it all together and get your hull all lined up. But you can see, I wanted to give you everyone a look at that full interior. Everything that should be in there looks awesome. The detail is phenomenal. And that will all be in there on your kit, so you can decide how far you want to detail yours, if you want to leave it removable or the hatches open so you can see inside. There's no reason to worry about the interior on this tank. It's absolutely beautiful. And those tiny little shells and a little building tidbit since we're here. You will need to drill some holes, which is extremely common. You just want to use a 1mm drill bit. You can get those anywhere. And you just want to drill your holes where it asks you to for things like smoke dischargers, mud scrapers, anything like that on the sidewalls of the hull and in various parts to attach parts. So I'm going to keep building. We'll come back for the subassembly, but I did want to show you that awesome interior that I will now be hiding inside the tank and not detailing on my build, but you can most certainly install it on yours. I mean, it's even got casting marks and everything, so you can enjoy a nice detailed build for your tank. See you in a second. To get the little tank to this point takes about 2.5-3 hours worth of work because it's so detailed. It's easy assembly, it's not difficult. The parts all fit well. The fit and finish is excellent from Italeri. So it just takes a while because of all the small details and extra things that they put on the tank. We got this little sweet ammo box with the three shells that you could put in it and decorate, which I'm going to. We've got our nice machine gun, which mounts on top of the hull up there. That's on its own little tree, so I can get that painted and detailed as well. We've got the ends of all the hubs for the road wheel assemblies and suspension. We're leaving those on their trees so I can get them painted and attached later. Also, the tools, the three tools and the mounts for the tools that are off the back of the tank, I left those off so I can spray these with a primer and then detail each one by hand, snip them loose, and attach them with super glue at the end. If I didn't, I know I would break all these little tool mounts completely off and destroy the whole thing. Same with the side steps, because I'm putting my treads on, my tank treads on later, the tracks, and the tow cable later. I want to paint these up, weather them, then I will go ahead and attach those side steps, and I'll go ahead and hang that tow cable from the front end, and I can still detail them, and I don't have to worry about breaking these gorgeously thin parts before I attach them. I'm going to use four fuel tanks on mine, so I did assemble those. You have even more for this parts container. Each fuel tank consists of four pieces, each half, the cap, and the handle. Excellent construction, go together nicely, but it's small things like that that will take you a little bit longer in this build. The tracks are ready to go. With that metallic tone, and it's beautiful too, it's a gunmetal tone, it's a tone I would have used on them to build them to begin with if they would have been cast in a black or if they, whatever. So what I'm going to do to get acrylics and craft paints to stick to these better is that I'm going to spray them with an acrylic matte clear, and you'll see that in the painting section. And then I can go ahead and we'll weather these up on camera and show you how I like to do it. Now the beautiful Semovente itself is all set up. Being 1/35th scale, it's not gigantic. It's about 6 inches long on the table, about 3 inches wide, a little less in each dimension. You can see the exquisite level of detail on here. The suspension, which these I'm leaving separate so that I can paint them. And the road wheels all spin, and that's going to help me. I'm going to show you how to paint rubber on road wheels, this many small road wheels, without having to do everything separately on toothpicks. But we've got our spring mount, each half of the suspension, and those beautiful double road wheels on there. That is a nice assembly that we can hang on later. And it also allows you to have the tank articulated when you assemble yours and build it. So we'll remove all of those. I just placed those on the side. I did attach the return rollers and the drive and return roller on the front and the back, because those will be painted up as the color of the tank itself. And then I can do a little bit of the rubber road wheel detailing, but these are pretty small and I wanted to get everything attached. Otherwise I knew I'd break it and lose it. Look at these awesome little teeth to retain the track on the drive wheel so it doesn't jump and skip off. Those are four individual pieces. You just drill the holes using that drill bit like I showed you. I use a little 1 millimeter drill bit from Harbor Freight and a little drill bit assortment that they sell for dirt cheap. If you wish to have the tank poseable, the gun will elevate on its mount. It will also go side to side. I put mine in place permanently because I'm not having the tank open, but the entire inside of the upper hull is decorated. Each hatch will open on this tank, all six of them. And you can display them open and display that entire gorgeous interior, display the engine transmission area. It's beautiful back there. And we've got our exhaust built up from multiple pieces. I've got the smoke discharger box back there with the extra road wheel. It's just a wonderful level of detail. We got the nice little grab handles on the sides. All this fun little hooks and equipment. And look at that little miniature tow hook back there. I love assembling these. They take a little bit longer than a car model, but they are fun to do something different every now and then. Now, painting this is going to be super easy. There's a picture online. I'm going to try to remember to put it in the beginning of the, or the end of the beginning or end of the painting section, so you can see the picture of a Semovente that I saw. I've done so many kits in a tan or desert camo that this one I'm going to do completely different. So I'm going to get it over to the painting section and I'll see you over there. Ci sento dolcino d'amor, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento dolcino d'amor. Non più vorrei questi bei panacchini, quel cappello leggero galante, quella chioma, quell'aria brillante, quel vermiglio d'onesco color, quel vermiglio d'onesco color. Non più vorrei quei panacchini, quel cappello, quella chioma, quell'aria brillante. Non ti trai farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girato, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tu a dolcino d'amor. Delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tu a dolcino d'amor. Fra guerrieri po' farbacco, quando stacchi stretto sacco, schioppo in spalla, sciabla a fianco, collo dritto, muso franco, un gran casco, un gran turbante, molto onor, poco cantante, poco cantante, poco cantante. Ed invece del fandango, una marcia per il fango, per montagni, per valloni, con le nevi e salioni, al concerto di tromboni, di bombarde, di cannoni, che le porre tutti tuoni, all'orecchio fan fischiar. Non più vrai quei penachini, non più vrai quel cappello, non più vrai quella chioma, non più vrai quell'aria brillante. Non più vrai farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno drato, delle belle
si sette quattro d'amor. Delle belle tornando al riposo, Narcisetta dolcino d'amor. Che rovino alla vittoria, alla gloria militar. Che rovino alla vittoria, alla gloria militar. Alla gloria militar, alla gloria militar. Non potrai far felogni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tua dolcino d'amor. Delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tua dolcino d'amor. Thank you.
Well, that's how easy it is to work and weather a solid color tank, yet have different colors on it. You can see that the tracks look great. That silver undertone of a raw metal track looks wonderful with a little bit of rust and dirt weathering on top of it, sealed with a clear coat of matte flat, like I showed in the painting section, and those tracks will go on lovely. Manual says they attach with super glue, so we'll just wrap those around and glue them in place. We got our little ammo box here that I did up the shells for and the box. That's going to look awesome. I'll just glue that somewhere up on top or something as a spare. You know, that could be any scene that this tank is involved in. Got our tools. Those will be glued on after I get the tracks on. One thing with tanks you'll always want to do, usually, is get your decals on right away like I did, so that you can start weathering and dirt over them, unlike a car where they'll be pretty clean. This one, I wanted to make sure I had them on, and then weathered over the top. Of course, mine is more of a fantasy vehicle in that gray color, using some of the cool-looking logos from the decal sheet, but made on my own, because I like that color that I saw on the internet, the way it looked, and that's the model that I wanted to make. The machine gun has been dry brushed. That will be attached, clipped off, and attached to the mount up there. We've got one fuel tank here. I've got the other three I decided to repaint for a little bit of contrast on the tank. We got the towing cable that I put some rust effects on, and the side steps that I put a little bit of a chip effect on with that metallic dry brushing as I showed in the painting section. You can see how nice that is looking with a little bit of a lighter gray over the darker gray, rusted out the exhaust, filled in all the vents so that they look like they're actual deep, did a little bit of that panel line accent, and it really makes things stick out like the hatches. It doesn't look like it's just one gray tank. It is monotone, but you can do things to enhance that like I showed and really make it stand out. So all I'm going to do is wrap the tracks around and glue on the little accessory items, and we'll be back for the final. As you can see, having fun and doing it your way can result in some of the most fun model kits that you'll ever build. I built up Italeri's 1/35th scale Semovente M42 DA75/18. They always got such long names on them, and it was a lot of fun. It's kit 6569. I will link down in the description where you can get yours on order, but it is a sharp machine, and it comes out looking pretty awesome if you just dedicate a little bit of time to it and have fun and don't worry about sweating the small stuff. If you decide, all these hatches open on the tank, and I showed you that really nicely detailed interior, full gun underneath these hatches. You can look at everything. It's got the two figures they say aren't included for this version, but of course you could paint those figures up and include them if you desired and get yourself a nice looking tank when you are all done with a full interior. This actual top here, it's not a turret on this one since it doesn't move, but what would be the very top of the tank with the main gun in it does remove if you don't want to glue it into place. It fits in very nicely. You could really get a great look at that interior drive line and how the gun works inside. So highly recommend it. This could easily be a first tank build. You're not going to have any fit problems. You're not going to have to fight anything. You won't have to assemble individual tank tracks. You got the nice rubber band tracks on there, which all go into place. You can see how nicely they settle down, give you a little bit of a sag to them, just like the real thing in the image here, and you're not going to have any problems at all. So I didn't weather mine heavily with dirt or dust. I wanted it more of a used universe, but not completely destroyed, and I always build for me. You can go ahead and build yours with the box style camo or one of the other three options in the box, or you can do the gray version like I did. I haven't done a German gray tank ever yet, and when I saw that picture online, I thought that'd be fun. A little bit of contrast on the tank is fun with the tow cable, the machine gun, the different colored jerry cans, the ammo container on the back with the shiny new shells ready to be fired, the rusted out muffler, the dirtied up and rusted a little bit tracks on there which get, you know, scraped right away, and the decals went down beautifully. Did not fight me at all. There's no silvering on the decals, even though it's a flat finish, and it all worked out real well. So thanks a million for MRC for sending this over. Again, this is out right now. I will link down in the description where you can snag yours, and we'll see all of you at the next review.